Hello everyone, today we shall discuss on a new feature which has been released, that is generation of auto debit note and credit note directly from invoice itself. Before getting into the working, I'd like to explain you the concept. I'll just give you a small example. Like for example, your vendor gives you an invoice of 10 pieces, but you actually receive 9. Then as per the current operation, what you used to do is that you used to create a goods receipt of 10 pieces, then do a purchase invoice of 10 pieces, then create one goods return and then create a purchase return document. What we have done is we are asking you to receive as per actual, and then whatever the difference is there between the actual and what is invoiced, you can specify that in the invoice itself. Let's understand this concept in a more detailed example. Now let's suppose vendor invoiced me 10 quantity of a product with the rate of 100 rupees and I received the same. Thus there is no difference and so no debit note or credit note will be generated automatically. Now if suppose I receive 9 pieces, then I am receiving short. So that means if I credit 1000 to the vendor, then 100 rupees debit note should automatically generated. Now if I receive excess, that is I receive 11 pieces, then 100 rupees credit note shall be auto generated. Now if there is a difference in rate, let's say the vendor invoiced me as per 100 rupees but I am receiving it as per 80 due to mutual agreement between me and the vendor, because this goods receipt impacts my costing. So there is a difference of 200 rupees coming in total. So I'll issue a debit note to the vendor. Now, if suppose there is a difference in both quantity and rate, so system will automatically calculate the total difference value. Now, since the difference value is coming to a positive side, so automatically system will issue a debit note. So if we consider this example, then total of 100, 200 and 280 will be the total basic amount for that particular debit note, and 100 rupees will be the basic amount for the credit note. Now let's see how this is mapped in the system. Here in the goods receipt window, I have already created a goods receipt as per the example specified in the previous slide. One is of 9 pieces, another is of 11 pieces. One there is a difference of rate and one where there is a difference of rate and quantity both. So I am now going to create a purchase invoice for the same. I go to the purchase invoice module. I select the supplier. I give the vendor invoice number and the invoice date. Now I select the goods received. Here you can see few additional fields are added: vendor invoice, quantity, rate, amount, and the existing columns are move to here in the scroll. Now as per our example, all the rates were of 100 rupees and all the invoice quantity was of 10. I am able to change it here. So now you can see here that there is a difference showing up here, but now my invoice will match as per the vendor's invoice. So it will ease my GST matching provisions as well. I'm selecting the correct term and doing calculate. Now once I save this, if I am having the auto release privilege, the adjustment entries will pass automatically. If I don't have the auto release privilege, once this purchase invoice is released, system will automatically generate those debit and credit notes. Here you can see the total basic amount of both debit and credit note matches with that of our slide. So once I save this, the adjustment entries are generated successfully because I had the auto release privilege. Now if I go to the purchase debit note menu, I can see that the basic amount of 580 for this debit note is getting tallied with 580 as specified in our example, and the credit note of 100 is getting tallied with the credit note basic amount of 100. Few important points I like to mention here: that the documents getting created will be created in an unposted state because you need to enter the debit note and the credit note number sent by the vendor, and you need to specify those here, and then only you will be able to release this particular transaction. Secondly, if you revert any purchase invoice against which automatic debit note or credit note is generated, system will ask you that those debit note or credit note will be deleted. Do you want to proceed? Yes, no. Once you select yes, those debit note or credit note will get deleted. Thank you so much for joining us today. For any further information on this, please contact Ginesys Care. Thank you.